guys, Simply Betta here. Today's just been a fun day of going to the library and reading lots of books to the toddler because they have this nice little baby room and I love it. So when I get home, I'm going to be making new worm cultures, new Grindal worm cultures, which will be fun because I love my worms. Okay, I have to go chase a baby.
You love the library, don't you, Riley?
Hey, get back here. Okay, I'm gonna feed Sheila her Repta-Boost supplement. Oh yeah, what is that, Sheila? Oh my gosh, that's good stuff. Whoops. Sorry, did I get that on your delicate chin? Sheila's a very clean lizard. She doesn't like food on her chin. Tonight, I'm gonna be expanding my Grindalworm cultures and kind of resetting and refreshing my Grindalworms. If you don't know what Grindalworms are, they're tiny little white worms that are pretty easy to culture. I'll show you an example. If I lift up this little lid here, you'll see all of... Oh, that's not a good example. I left some dog food in there. Their food was a little too much, and I didn't change it out, and it got a little moldy. So instead of showing you a gross moldy thing, I'll be showing you a... Oh yeah, Taylor, that's not gross at all. It's not nearly as gross. These are my Grindalworms. This is a nice healthy culture I have. It produces really well. So Grindalworms, they're easy to cultivate. They're really great for fish, like even Bettas. I'm trying to get a good focus with my camera phone here. But they're a really good size to feed not only to growing fry, but also to adults. Grindalworms are big enough for adult Bettas to enjoy too. And heck, if you have guppies or any kind of small fish, they would go nuts over Grindalworms. So tonight I'll be refreshing my Grindalworm cultures so they'll stay nice and healthy and producing for me, and I'm also making more. I'm going to test making a really big culture like this because I have a lot of mouths to feed. I'd like to have a really large culture that I could just take a ton of worms from. So I'm using this Rubbermaid bin. And then I've also been saving up plastic containers from my recycle bin for a while now. I have 14 just, you know, regular old average Joe recycled plastic containers. I poked a little hole in the lids. And I'll be using these to make little cultures. My goal is to be able to offer some little Grindalworm cultures that are actually cultures, like they've been culturing for a few weeks and are producing well. On my online store. That's the ultimate goal, I think. As long as, I'm sure people won't mind that I'm using recycled plastic containers. I think it's silly to have to go buy brand new plastic containers just to hold a few worms. For substrate, I have regular potting soil, like an organic potting soil, and I also have cocoa fiber. Yeah, cocoa fiber. And I'll try both of them. I have the feeling that the cocoa fiber is going to be a little messier than the garden soil, but I actually don't know. That's why I'm trying like half and half, and we'll just see which one I like more. I'm totally wearing gloves for this because the last thing I want is wormy dirt stuck under my nails for days. I don't mind worms, but that does not sound very nice. If you've been following my channel for a while, you might recognize this little dog as the one who eats rare and expensive aquatic plants. Yeah, she has a taste for them. So first thing I did was I added a bunch of tank water to my soil. This is my potting soil here. It's nice and moist. Perfect consistency for like a worm to live in. Same with the cocoa fiber here. It's a nice consistency. If I really squeeze it, just a little bit of water drips out, but not that much. I think that's pretty good to start with. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out about half of the soil in each of my Grindalworm cultures. I've been feeding kind of on the far side, so hopefully all the worms are over on the far side while I take the old stuff that's kind of over here. And hopefully that'll help extend my culture a little bit and prevent any crashes. I took out a nice big chunk out of each Grindalworm culture of the old soil, and you could tell it was kind of old. I didn't do anything out of this one. That's my newer culture. It seemed just fine, so I guess I'm not going to mess around with this one. Okay, I replaced two of them with potting soil and one with the cocoa fiber just to see if any difference is going to be made. My dogs are disgusting, and they're just hovering around me because they want to eat my gross worm dirt. What's wrong with you dogs? Now I'll start feeding on the side with the fresh dirt, and in a couple weeks, I'll take the old dirt from this side and do the same exact thing. Here are my recycled containers I'm going to use for my new cultures. So my plan is that I'm going to take a little handful of the old dirt that I removed from my cultures and just put that in the bottom. I don't know if this is actually going to work, but the idea is that there are worms and eggs in here, and maybe it'll help jumpstart my culture a bit. Then I'll fill the rest up with, let's do cocoa fiber. Went ahead and I repeated the same step, but with my remaining containers and potting soil. Stop trying to eat it. I poured all my remaining cocoa fiber into this tub. So guys, I'm gonna get some really good grindleworm populations going. Grindleworms are great. If you could keep one easy live food, it'd probably be grindleworms. They can be kept at room temperature. I just feed mine dog kibble, and they reproduce really well, and fish go crazy over them. So do small dogs. I'm gonna feed these guys while I talk. So now, whenever I go to feed grindleworms for the day, I'm going to reserve some of them to put into my cultures. And I'm not taking out any right now, I'm just feeding them to show you guys. And to feed them, all I do is I pour some dog kibble into some tank water, and I let it just get wet for a minute, like so. I just sprinkle it right there, and the worms go to town. I'm going to start kind of trying to transition them over to the new soil. Like I'll put a kibble there, and also I'm going to put a couple in the middle, and they'll start moving over. Yeah, just to show you an example of how I'm going to start all my cultures, dog, leave the kibbles alone, Bubbles. So basically, I just scoop up a bunch of worms, and this is how I harvest the worms, is I scoop them up with my finger, and I drop them into some water, and usually I get a whole bunch in my water, and then I just suck it up with a turkey baster or a syringe, and my camera's not really focusing, but there's a whole bunch of worms floating around in there. It's really great. So then to start my cultures, I'm just going to plop a little piece of kibble or two down in the middle of my culture and pour them on. Pour them right in the area. And that's really going to get them started. They're right on top of the food. And it's going to take them a while to fill up this whole, you know, container. But every time I harvest some worms, I'm going to set some aside and pour them into these containers too, and pretty soon I'll have a whole bunch of thriving containers. So this daily video vlog challenge was all about worms. Just worms. How many subscribers did I lose, Bubbles? This will just be audio. Oh well, I guess some people just don't like worms as much as I do. Thanks for watching, guys. This is, I think, video 15. I'm over halfway done with my daily February video challenge. Thanks for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you tomorrow.